spirit of the living God. Out of the singing song. It's a Yoruba song. But I know that many of us know this song.
has pleased you, the Almighty God, to keep us alive today. We bless your name. We glorify you. We adore you. May your name be known continually, be glorified in the name of Jesus. Lord, we are gathered again in your presence today. The Bible says in your presence, there is fullness of joy and pleasure forevermore. Lord, we pray that as we gather in your presence today, let your mighty presence be mightily present with us. In the name of Jesus, any power anywhere assigned to distort what you have for your people today, so as to present presents to those who are presently present in your presence. Lord, I pray, let our heavens be open and let our presence be presented to us. In the name of Jesus, let no man, let no woman go out of this place today without receiving bountiful blessings in the name of Jesus. Jesus' name we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's be seated. We are all blessed in Jesus' name. I bring greetings from our Father in the Lord. The General Overseer of Mountain of Fire Miracles Ministries. Dr. D.K. Olukoye. He sent me to greet you. And I am greeting you now. You don't have interpretation for that. So that's why I'm seeing you. Amen. Yeah. It's good to be here again. Remember the last time I was here was 2015. Yes. I remember it in 2015. And I'm happy to be here again.
Hallelujah.
Turn your Bible with me into that passage of the scriptures we read as our Bible reading. Exodus chapter 14. But I'm going to read quickly from verse 8. Exodus chapter 14. From verse 8. I titled the message, Power for Progress. Power for Progress. Exodus chapter 14. From verse 8. And the Lord hardened the heart of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and he pursued after the children of Israel. And the children of Israel went out with an high hand, but the Egyptians pursued after them, all the horses and chariots of Pharaoh and his horsemen and his army, and overtook them encamping by the sea beside the Ahirot before Baal-Zephon. And when Pharaoh drew nigh, the children of Israel lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them. And they were so afraid. And the children of Israel cried out unto the Lord. And they said unto Moses, because there were no graves in Egypt, hast thou taken us away to die in the wilderness? Wherefore hast thou then thus with us, to carry us forth out of Egypt? Is not this the word that we did tell thee in Egypt, saying, let us alone, that we may serve the Egyptians? For it had been better for us to serve the Egyptians than that we should die in the wilderness. I pray for somebody here this morning. Any power that says you will continually serve your enemies, that power shall die. Verse 13.
And Moses said unto the people, Fear ye not, stand still, and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will show you today. For the Egyptians whom ye have seen today, ye shall see them again no more forever. The Lord shall fight for you, and ye shall hold your peace. Verse 15. That nullifies the amen you have just said. And the Lord said unto Moses, Wherefore criest thou unto me? Speak unto the children of Israel that they go forward. Now, what we have read now is the event of what happened when the children of Israel left the land of Egypt. They were going to the promised land. And with a high hand, they were delivered out of captivity. And on their way, God did something. One, God told Moses not to take the children of Israel through the normal way they normally come to Egypt. Two, he told them to go through the way of the Red Sea. Is that not strange? We have the road our forefathers have been going through. Now you now say we should go through the way of the Red Sea. And in obedience, they followed Moses like M-U-M-U. When they got to the back of the Red Sea, they look front. They are standing before them, the Red Sea. They look back. They saw Pharaoh and his army. They look to the right. Mountain. They look to the left. They look down. Can't soil underneath their feet. They look up. Ever too far. No ladder to climb up. So they were surrounded and encamped from all the six ways that enters into their life. There was no way for them. Moshe, as a man of God, did what an average minister of God would do. He gave the people a word of encouragement. He said, stand still and see the salvation which the Lord will show you today. And gave a prophecy that these Egyptians you are seeing today, you will see them again no more forever. Meanwhile, the people were complaining that Moses, look at you. You know the hear word. We told you before that you should leave us alone. Leave us alone to continue to serve our enemies. Now, are you now telling us that there are no grace in Egypt? That we will now perish here so that we will not be given any befitting burial. We didn't complain to you that we were tired of serving our enemies. We that word of encouragement. Because under a normal situation, when you carry a problem or a challenge to any man of God, to God. He prayed unto God. The answer of God was in, is in verse
15.
Said Moses, why are you crying to me? Why did you ask the children of Israel to stand still? Tell them to go forward. Ordinarily, if you don't have strong and unshakable faith in the Lord, you will doubt the statement God made. You will say, God, move forward to where? Into the sea? Are you blind? You don't know that this is sea? I move forward. Will the people follow me? But as a man of faith, he listened and hearkened to the voice of God. In verse 16, God said, what is that in your head? Said rod. Don't forget that rod was formerly the rod of Moses. But it has now become the rod of God to wrought miracles. And the moment Moses stretched forth the rod, the Red Sea parted. And anyone, an expressway that was not built by any earthly construction company. This, now water congeal like this. How come? They went to the other side. They thought the water became rock solid. They stepped down. Expressway. Their stubbornness and their stupidity were all orchestrated by God. Because the earlier verses, the Bible says, God himself is the one that said, I will harden the heart of Pharaoh. So they stupidly entered and was passing through the same Red Sea that became an expressway. Moses looked back. He saw the armies of Pharaoh at the middle. And God gave him another command. Stretch forth that same rod. And close up this expressway. And the moment he stretched forth the rod, the Red Sea came together again. The wall was broken. The congealed water became a flowing water. And the armies of Pharaoh, they perished. You know what thing surprised me? God will destroy your enemies. As they entered to the expressway, somehow, the wheel from the chariot began to remove one after the other. Spare me. Who was removing their wheel? Before the Red Sea came together again, some of them were already somersaulting and falling from their chariot. Because certain powers began to remove the wheel. The knots began to remove one after the other. Because they had entered a road of destruction. The same Red Sea that served as a source of salvation and deliverance for the children of Israel became a source of destruction for their enemies. That will be the portion of somebody here this morning. In the name of Jesus. Be seated. Beloved, Moses was so sensitive to the leading and direction of God. That's why we need to be praying a particular prayer. That God, at any point in time, sharpen my spiritual sensitivity. Signals from heaven. Because if the children of Israel, Moses had not been sensitive, and the children of Israel had stood still, the Egyptians would have caught up with them and destroyed them. But he was so sensitive. He moved at the move of God. The man of God said, if you don't move with the move of God, God will move without you, and everything around you will stop moving. So we need our antenna to be able to pick the signals from heaven. May powers of darkness not clip your antenna. In the name of Jesus. Because Moses said, you stand still. But God said they should go forward. That they should make progress. That they should advance. That they should move forward. The desire of God for you and I is to move forward and make progress. While preparing this message, I began to all sorts of Bible passages, of Bible verses. Moses, why are you praying? For what match? So God wants every one of us to make progress in life. And what is progress? Progress means advancement. Progress means promotion. Progress means expansion. Progress means enlargement. Progress means forward movement. Progress means marching forward. There is an adage that says that if you cannot fly, run. If you cannot run, walk. If you cannot walk, your latter age should greatly increase. You may start
minuscule. You must progress. You must become bigger and bigger. It's like a shining light that shines more and more until perfect day. So God does not desire that we remain at the spot. He wants us to keep on increasing and improving. I decree upon somebody here this morning, any area of your life that is stationary, from this very moment, you begin to move forward.
Tomorrow is better than today.
prophecy every other contrary prophecy is from the pit of hell. You want to know your tomorrow? Had your yesterday plus your today. That will equal you to your tomorrow. If we did not progress from yesterday, we would not have entered today. So your progress of today will determine where you are going to be tomorrow. Why must you progress? So that you don't become a byword or a forgotten history. You know why someone becomes a byword? Such a person will be existing but not alive. It's possible to exist and you are not alive. Just like two young guys. They were going on the road. They were passing in front of a particular building. And one of them began to point to one of the two men standing at the balcony of that building. Said, my friend, look at that man. That
young one.
When he was a man,
has
he become a woman? That guy was telling the friend that when that man was a real man, those days when he was still living, but now he has become a walking corpse. That will not be our portion in the name of Jesus. Why must you make progress? You need to make progress so as to put your enemies to shame. Who doesn't have enemies? Everybody has enemies. In fact, the Bible says that the enemies of a man are the people of his own household. Everybody has enemies. If you are tall, you have enemies. You say you are tall like dogonyaro tree. If you are short, he said you are a short man devil. If you are fat, they say you are horrible. Or fatty bongo. If you are slim, they say you are lepacious. It's just like a broom. If you are yellow, they say you are artificial yellow bobo. If you are black, they say you are black like Jacko. Are you from Northern Ghana? If you are married, you have enemies. Many of those who are not married will not like you. Some of them, their secret prayer is that you should misbehave. So that that man can throw you out. So that they can enter. If you have children, you have many enemies. Especially when you have like 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 years. Children you are supposed to give birth to in this witchcraft
cover.
If you have money, you have enemies. He said, you did money ritual. Remember those sisters that were complaining that their pants got missing? He
that they like you. I had an experience in Lagos. I was just driving gently. Somebody said to me, Mr. Ma,
Harry,
this is your bank, look, come over the road. Let somebody pass. This is not a freeway. And if you are driving,
how are
you? You are running. See you. So that we can know you have
one.
And when you don't press your home, Mr. Man. The MC, the master of ceremony,
we are not MC.
Just announced.
Abua Ari.
Praise the Lord, somebody.
Please,
this is the order of our reception meal. If you are here with your car, please, you are okay. If you are not here with your car, this set of people I want to mention, we have executive air-conditioned buses outside there. Just majestically move to that bus.
If you
are here with your car, just drive and follow the bus. We did wedding at VI. The reception meal was to be taken at Sheraton Hotel and Towers. By the time we will finish the announcement,
you
just said, "Oh, our wonderful choir, our honorable guests, our ministers, you are the ones this announcement concerned. The rest of you, sit here, we will serve you." You know what saved me that day? I was the one that drove my uncle there. And he will not drive himself back. Then we were living at Maryland. So that was how I got the opportunity of being among the best people that went to Sheraton. Bottles of juice. That incident alone,
you are not fair.
Give me a prayer point. I'm
going
to pray. God, remove me from among the rest. Put me among the best. And the ministry today, without sounding proud, I don't move with riff-raff ministers. If I tell you some men of God that I move with, they are the movers and shakers in the land. They are not just useless pastors, but real, genuinely anointed and great men. Men of God, that somebody will see you with them. So when I told you that our daddy in the Lord sent me now, you all gave me attention. Suppose I did not know you. Suppose I didn't know him. I know if I come to pastor that I'm anointed, I'm the junior brother of Jesus, I just came down from now. Sir, I've heard you. Please sit among the congregation. Yes. May God remove you from among the rest. I put you among the best. I came with a great man of God.
This morning,
he went to Centurion to minister. It is God though that is promoting you, and it is not me. Because I'm just a village boy. I came from a village that if you are plotting the map of Nigeria, my village will not get a dot. But I keep on praying that prayer. Because I'm not going to where I'm going.
I'm
still making progress. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Now, why is it that many are not progressing?
Then we go and
pray. Number one reason why. why many of us are not making progress in life. Secret sins. Oh, secret sins. Proverbs 28:13 says that he that covereth his sin will not prosper. So please, if you are always engaging in secret sins, one day your sin will find you out. Secret sins. You know the language of sin. Cover me, I destroy you gradually. Expose me. I run away from you. If you are in the habit of committing sin secretly, you will begin to sink. Because sin is a sinker. A sinning believer is a sinking believer.
Would you make it all right? Let's say, baby, would you make it all
right? If you know how to commit sin, you must also be ready to suffer. Number two reason why many are not progressing is disobedience and stubbornness. Many will never obey God. And I remember some years ago, a profound statement.
Said
99.9 obedience is equal to disobedience. There is nothing like partial obedience. If you are in the habit of disobeying God's direction, either through his word, disobeying his direction from men of God, you will never make progress. Why many of us are suffering and we are not making progress? It's because we are so stubborn and we always want to have our way. If you always want to have your way, God will leave you.
Would
you
want
that to
be on your own?
Another reason why many are not progressing is when you are satisfied with average or the level you are. So much that no earthly computer will be able to compute yourself. At least in the few years I've been coming, I've seen different kinds of people. In fact, some people, I just pray you have the opportunity of showing this our latest movie. Pastor already has it. Maybe we do a program and show it. Some people will have to go back home. Does my God send me the message?
Maybe
I said I was surprised. We shot part of it here last year.
The
remaining part in Nigeria. God will help us.
Another
reason why many are not making progress is wrong foundation. The Bible says that if the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? after many years of research and prayers, I discovered an answer. The following verse did not give us the answer, but I've discovered the answer. Can I tell you the answer? If the foundation be destroyed, what can the righteous do? The righteous will suffer. Unless something is done to relay the wrong foundation. Our foundation, our background that has put our back on the ground. It will be the foundation of your marriage. No, it's very common here. Somebody you are not married to, you are sleeping in his house. And he's sleeping with you. Why is it that some people are not making progress? Not that I'm afraid of you. If you get rich, I'm the father of witches. That's why God gave me the instruction to do a movie, witchcraft in the church. And if you are a witch, you can't get me. Because apart from the fact that I am inside Jesus, I'm also inside our Father in the Lord. So you have to witch Jesus, witch our Father in the Lord, witch some fathers in the Lord that I have before you will ever get to me. So don't embark on a journey of no return. Laziness and indolence. Some people are not too lazy. You get them in work, they will not do. And they keep on asking you to give them money. You are being taught how to fish. You don't want to learn how to fish. You always want people to be giving you fish. One day, they will stop.
But
you will be on your own. Another reason why many are not progressing is when you are impatient with God.
So
some people are down to impatient with God. They want to run ahead of God. Do you even know the way that you want to run ahead of God? We need to be patient with God. This thing. Look, there are four ways God answers prayer. Number one way, you pray, God answer instantaneously. It's as if He has been waiting for you to talk. You pray at times. Say, pray more. You pray at times. Say, wait. And the third way. You pray. Say, capital M-O. When the answer is no.
How much about the hand?
Just be praying. God, let your grace be sufficient for
them.
It's not everything we pray for that God will give to us. I'm coming of the Lord.
God.
May it take 1,000 years. I was telling some
pastors 2 days ago. So when God says, wait, you better go and marry Sister Patience. And be patient with him. Why is that the dead generation of the apostles will not pass before he comes back? It's in the Bible. I'm not speaking outside the Bible. Behold, I come quickly. According to his work. And he said, the dead generation of the apostles will not pass. Has he come?
You
might not come in the next 50 years. Your Lord Jesus has come. Why is it that many are not making progress? Moving with the wrong set of people. Where you move with the wrong set of people? If you move with people that are always regressing, you can never make progress. Amen. How do you make progress? Jump to that and we pray. How do you make progress in life? Number one, you must surrender to Jesus in totality. It must not only be your Savior, it must be your Lord. And if it's your Lord, whatever He commands, you must obey. Number two, to make progress, you must be obedient to God in every area of your life. To make progress in life, you must be spiritually sensitive to His leading and direction. To make progress in life, you must give yourself to RSMM. What is RSMM?
King RSMM.
You want to make progress? Read the Bible. Study the Bible. Meditate on the Bible. And memorize the Bible. Because many times, prayer for progress will be answered according to the word of God that you have inside you. Read the Bible. Meditate on the Bible. Reading is quite different from studying. Studying is different from meditating. Meditating on is different from memorizing. We are conducting deliverance in the church for one sister. I'm not the senior pastor. It was the senior pastor that called me and one evangelist and one other brother that we should pray for a particular sister. He put the sister in the window like this. And the three of us surrounded her. We began to pray. I've never seen that kind of manifestation. This sister, her two legs will be lifted from the ground. She will move like this. When her head is about touching the ceiling, she will come down. To tell you the truth, I was afraid. Honestly, I was using style. We began to quote scriptures. As we are quoting scriptures, she became violent. I am the evangelist.
The top brother with us carried his Bible. He began to open. Now let me ask you this. Is it a crime to open Bible while praying for somebody? Answer me. No. But I learned a lesson that day. As this sister became violent, and our brother was opening
the Bible,
he was actually looking for places he has marked in the Bible to also quote. Just like a flash, the sister kicked the Bible out of his hand. Quote from your heart. Can't you see your mates? So demons know those who have the word of God inside them. From that day, I began memorizing scriptures. You know, I discovered something. Many of our prayers are not being answered, not because we are committing sin, but because our prayers are not scripturally based. So give yourself to the word of God. There are times all our prayer rhetorics will not move anything. It is the word that will work wonders. Rise up on your
knees.
I want us to pray. Finally,
to
make progress, you must be ready to pray. Scripturally based prayers. Pray Holy Ghost committed prayer
thoughts.
And our first prayer this morning is this.
ignorantly.
Mighty name we have.